Hello, ladies and gents. Welcome to another episode of
The Skooled Zone.
I felt like I needed to say ladies and gents because we are in Victoria, London, eh? My British accent is shoddy at best, but I'm getting back into the feel of the scene after playing three other games in between the last episode. But we are back in black and ready to rock some Syndicate here. When we last left off, we had just met Henry Green, got to play some horse and buggy demolition derby, and now we're about to meet Henry in his curio shop to learn about our next mission. So let's do this.
Did you give them the slip?
We gave them more than that.
Who are all these people?
Over the years, I have established a number of connections across the city.
Splendid. We'll need focused aid.
Focused aid? We take over Starrick's gangs, we cripple his control.
You're not aiming high enough. Starrick has influence in every branch of society. We need to match him.
I see what you're saying, Evie. We need the Rooks.
You are not starting a gang called the Rooks.
I believe I may have an idea of my own. We will need the police to turn a blind eye to activities. My ally in the force, Sergeant Abberline. I've heard he's a master of disguise. Next up, urchins.
Urchins?
Urchins. Children make for excellent spies.
Clara O'Day.
Smart as a whip, that one.
Finally, you would be wise to remember that Starrick never acts alone. There are gang leaders in every borough. You'll meet them soon enough, no doubt.
Rexford Kaylock. Known for his ability to vanish before your very eyes.
Should we make him vanish for real?
I suppose.
One moment. A Templar target you might want to look into. Be cautious. It's rough out there.
No, don't worry about me, Greeny. I can handle a few thugs.
All right, very cool, very cool. Somewhere that's green. So Henry mentioned Abberline in his little monologue there. The first thing that came to mind was Jack the Ripper. Frederick Abberline was the lead detective for Scotland Yard during the time of the Ripper murders. So it's amazingly apropos that he will make an appearance in the game. And I heard Jack the Ripper himself is going to be one of the DLCs available in December. So I'm eagerly awaiting that. Should be amazing if the game itself is any indication. He mentioned Rexford Kaylock. Rexford Kaylock is not a real historical figure, just a fictional target here. And he mentioned the word urchin. An urchin is a homeless child living on the streets. It comes from the old English word for hedgehog, which is why sea urchins are also called sea hedgehogs. But anyway, street urchins were quite common in Victorian London because of the great wealth inequality of the time. Not unlike today, to be honest. Fortunately, there are more mechanisms these days to help take kids off the streets that weren't available back then. So kids back then often formed into groups and would resort to petty crime to survive. Thus, another one of Charles Dickens' famous novels, Oliver Twist. All right. Actually, oh, cool. London map. All right, all right. Things are opening up here. The Templar crime boss. Look at him with his purple tie. That symbol he's got on almost kind of looks like a Wehrmacht Iron Cross. I actually talked about that in the Sniper Elite series. I'll put a little link to that episode up in the iCard if you want to check it out. All right. So, let's maybe unlock a territory. How about that? That'd be kind of fun. Oh, there's a shop. I definitely want to do some shopping. Chest. I'll check that out in a bit. Harold Drake. I don't think he's a real historical figure. Well, let's go for that first. I think I want to do that one next, because having a little network of kid spies would be badass. All right, so I am actually going to... Oh, we can zoom out. Nice. I'll talk about each of these boroughs and give you a few factoids about them, make it interesting as we get to each of those sections. I talked about Whitechapel quite a bit in the first or second episode, I think. Man, look at that map. It's almost 3D. That is just so cool. What is this? Okay, that's where I am. Yeah, I'm impressed with that. See, I always wanted to have a game that had an overhead map that looked kind of 3D like this, and it's starting to come together, guys. Games are getting awesome. I talked a little bit about that in last Friday's homeroom announcements. Okay, so let's move on to this one. Actually, let's swing over to this shop right here. Oh, there's a shop right there. Let's do that. Can I mark it? Did I set a marker? Okay, nice. All right, so let's do that.
What's the plan then, oh mighty planner?
You're the one with the grand ideas. The gangs, the fights, even the outfits you'll wear. Perhaps you should lead the way.
If you insist.
All right, I'm going to just check out. Oh, there we go. That answered my question right there. Oh, this is so cool. You know what I have a feeling you can do? I think you can customize the characters according to like certain pathways, maybe is the word I'm trying to say. Like, let's do that and I'll show what I'm talking about. Okay, switch to Eevee. Okay, all right, 6 points available. Let's do that. Oh, I have 3 between them. I gotcha. Okay, so this is what I was going to say. I think I'm going to try to make Eevee the more stealthy one and do the lock picking. So we'll definitely pick that up. And then I'll make Jacob the more combat-oriented crafter guy. Or maybe I'll make him like the tougher, healthier one. But you can definitely kind of go that route. So let's save those 2 points for now. And I'm going to switch back to Jacob and spend his points. Okay, so I already picked up lock picking for him because I forgot you can spend them separately, but I will take him the more combat-oriented route, or at least pick up some more crafting resources. So many decisions. See what this is again. Yeah, let's pick this one up. A new level. Ooh, neat. Oh, now I can this is cool. Oh, that's awesome. Okay, I'm going to save this point, but I think maybe I can go back to Eevee now and maybe get her the next level of stealth. Let's see if I can do that. Oh. Nope, she's still level 1. Okay, well, let's play her a little bit and okay, a little microtransactions there. Okay, well, let's play her to get her a few extra points, because I don't think they go on the missions together, do they?
I've got this.
Maybe not. Okay, so I don't think you can play them together. I think they're sort of separate. So she'll go on this mission. We'll kind of level her up a little bit. Let's check out where we're going again. Which one's the map? There we go. So, what's that thing right there? Helix credits. Okay. So let's head over to this shop right here. I'm running right at you, horse. Playing chicken. Oop.
I'll deal with you personally.
As much as I'd love to kill all the enemies we encounter, I feel like we kind of probably have to move on a little bit. I also have a feeling I could probably hijack one of these carriages as well. Well, look at that symbol on the wall. Is there something going on over here? He was messing with those fools and I taught him a lesson. She is just too cool for school. She is just manhandling that guy. Look at that. Oh, he got one in on me. Nope, I don't think so. Okay, so now we can get back to biz. Oh, there's a little bottle over there. Let's see what that's all about. Well, look at that. Nice little refreshing bottle of beer after a fight. Collecting beer bottles. That's trippy. I'm gonna have to... Well, I love that. I love that. She is just awesome. Okay, so apparently this shopkeeper wasn't too, Can I loot him? Or her? Oh no, that's right, I have the loot takedown. Gotta love it. Alright, so apparently he wasn't too scared off. Let's see what we can buy from him. Wow, we're actually doing pretty good. I could buy another smoke bomb, but, eh. Treasure maps. Those are pretty expensive, but the one for Whitechapel is only 1,000. We'll probably make that up in a few chests, actually, so let's go ahead and pick that up. Okay, that's worth it. All right, well, let's keep moving. Won't find better prices than these. Oh, we got something right here, as a matter of fact. A chest. See, we're a third of the way there of having it paid for. Okay, well, let's head up to this little conservatory. I actually talked about conservatories in the Dishonored episode. You'll probably hear me saying that quite a bit during my walkthroughs, having referenced other vocabulary words or factoids, and you guys can always go to the Skooled Zone website. When you go to the website, you can go up to the Knowledge tab, and then click on questions answered and then scroll down or use search to find that particular factoid, and then it'll take you directly to the episode. Okay, so we found the little skylight here. Let's do our little eagle vision. No mishaps. Oh, I didn't want to do that just yet. Okay, so we got two guys over there, and our target's somewhere over there. How many crates do we have left to distribute? Can we hop right onto this little... Oh, that is so cool. So cool. Well, before we start assassinating everybody, let me just take a quick peek around here. Oh, there he is.
Very good, sir.
Identify, what's that? Oh, there we go. There we go. Okay, so if I kill him with a crate of dynamite, we'll get a little bonus. I wonder if I can do that. Without harm. No mishaps. I think those little white things right there maybe are crates of dynamite. Okay, I didn't mean to do that. I was actually trying to figure out how to get around there. You know what? I'm going to switch to the gun, and then maybe I can shoot one of them. Can I hop over? Wouldn't it be cool if I could hop over to that clock? Let me try it. Oh, I can. Oh, he is so dead. Okay, the moment he walks over there, I'm shooting that thing.
Very good, sir.
Come on, homie. Want this to come into the blighter's hands without harm. Come on, homie. Give me that bonus. You know you want to walk over there. Here he comes. Doom. Kablam! Oh, we did it. We did it. They don't even know. Can I shoot that guy in the head? I can. Oh, they know where we are now. All right, well, let's go ahead and escape. Right through the roof. You gotta love it. You gotta love it. Now, there was a chest down there. I want to get that. So why don't we let them calm down for a minute? Are they going to try to get up here to the roof? Let's switch back to the knives. That was a little more stealthy. Oh, that was so much fun. Oh my gosh. Vanish. There we go. That's exactly what I wanted. Now we can go back in and, oh, there's another chest right there. Okay, we're just gonna have to do that real quick. She rocks. Chemicals and leather. Sounds like a party. Okay, so let's head back up. Head back through that little skylight and do our thing again. I'll probably have to re-identify him now. Retarget him. Here, let's see if we can knife this guy. Right. There we go. It's so quick and mean. It's just down and dirty, you know what I mean? Oh, did they all leave the area? They were like, screw this, man. We're not getting paid no mo. All right. Where was he? Ah, whatevs. Let's just go grab that, that chest and then escape the area. Where was it? It's right there. Pick lock. Colors, green. Let's go up here and see what that's all about. Colors, oh, I know what that is. Probably go into inventory and change her outfit. Oh, colors, right here. Green. Is that this one? Nice. Yeah, let's equip it. Make her a little bit of a female Robin Hood. Or maybe Poison Ivy. I don't know. Can't think of any other female superheroes that wear green, but that is really cool. Okay, so, man, this game is just enchanting, man. I just can't get enough. Okay, well, let's go ahead and run out of this area. Escape. That's right. Oh, look at that. Very cool. Loyalty level. Ruby Kukri. That sounds promising. Okay, that was fun. I like doing the little side objectives here. Oh, awesome. And it liberates the area, too. Totally forgot about that. Okay, there's so many more things to pick up around here. I probably won't waste your time. I'll just kind of do it. You know, if I happen to be running by, but I want to head all the way over here now and take care of the kids because, you know, who doesn't want to save some kids? All right. That sounds cool. So let's do that. They'll end up in the river. Oh, I've earned a skill point. Did I gain a level though? No, I'm still level 1. What's this? Kill criminals. Oh, look at that. She just hopped on the dude. Oh no, oh no. Oh no, the constables got involved. I was just trying to be a good Samaritan. Look at that. That's heinous. That's heinous. That's what you get for being a vigilante. All right, well, that's a good little thing to take note of. If you're going to help the innocent civilians, the constables will not approve. By the way, in case you are curious why they call them constables, the word comes from the Latin word for the count of stables. Back in the Roman Empire, the head stablemaster for a monarch also entailed being on horseback patrol duty around the estate. So there you go. Count of the stables, count stables, constables. All right, so where is it going to put us now? All right, so without further ado... No, we're not going to stick around for that. Okay, so let's remark where we want to go, because I think it unmarks it when you desynchronize. There we go. Wait, it didn't. Yeah, that's still liberated. Okay, so we're good. We're good. We will hold off on saving the civilians until we get into a more advantageous position. What was that? Oh, man, that's like tackle thief. It's just a kid, though. Oh, good, 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 good.
Hand it over, if you please.
She just reprimands him. I thought she was going to tackle the kid. Okay, we can do stuff like that. All right, that was kind of cool, actually.
You do not want to bother me today.
Looks like a mess, isn't
it? Yeah, this is all gang territory. I have a feeling that when you liberate an area, you can run down the street and not have to worry about that stuff anymore, but... There's a chest over there. Let's not worry about it. Hijack driver. Yeah, that's what I was thinking if you wanted to get around a little faster. But you know what? Running, it seems like it's almost as fast, and it's a whole, you got a whole lot more control over it.
You think these streets belong to you?
All right, well, let's just go ahead and go on up over. Can't wait till we get that grappling hook. That's gonna be wicked. Okay, let's see what we got here. Where does this thing start? It probably starts over here, so let me head on over here. Mark. Let's try over here, maybe? Okay, so I guess we have to talk to that person. I think that's... that what we do? Okay, let's do that. Oh, that's what it is? You're meeting bro. To catch an urchin. Kind of sounds like to kill a mockingbird, huh? Could be a nod to that, you never know. So that was Big Ben. We'll talk a lot more about Big Ben on an upcoming mission, don't you worry.
What is this place?
It's nice to meet you both at last. This is Babylon Alley, Here, we make it our business to know the streets and provide children with the opportunity to control their own destinies.
Clara, Mr. Green said we might be able to help one another.
In exchange for our services, we ask a small favor.
Well, why not? You seem to have taken most of my money. Why not take a small favor, too?
There are several factories about the city that are powered almost entirely by child labor. Those children work long hours with little pay, and most are not permitted even to leave the factory grounds. They suffer terribly. I need you to save them.
A small favor.
In return, we offer you intelligence, something you clearly need.
Oh, hold on a minute.
I'm late for an appointment. What are these terms?
We accept.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Wasn't she a little player? All right, that was cool. Okay, so yeah, it's all coming back to me now. Whenever you start a mission, you got to go kind of get the setup for it. So neither Clara O'Day nor Babylon Alley are real in history, but that's cool. You know, they got to make some stuff fictional, you know? Oh, I don't want to do that. That's a better thing to aim with. The sawmill. Okay, so we don't want him working in no sawmill. Okay, so this is where we go. Let's see if we can mark some people. Mark, there we go. Can't mark him yet. Oh, he's marked. Alarm bells. Oh, I remember those too. Okay. As much as I want to knife that guy, I feel like that'll set off the alarm. You know what? Just for the heck of it, let's see if there's a way to get in through the top. She's like, don't mind me. I'm just going to sneak on past you. Is there a way? That would be cool. Oh, hey, dude. Oh, there is. There is. There is. Loving it. Loving it. See if there's a way I can get in through, like, the very top. Another skylight, perhaps? Seems like I can pull one of those open, but... not in the cards? Okay, well, we found one way in through the top. Always better than going through the ground floor. Let's see. Is there a way to... nope. Okay, well, that one place was not bad at all, so let's do that. Okay, I don't want to go all the way up there. Oh my goodness. Come on back down. Okay. You know, despite little moments like that, the controls are very snappy in this game. So much more responsive than previous games. Okay, let's do a little... okay, so there's one guy there. Oh, I feel like I can knife him. Oh, nope. Not quite. Oh, he's gonna come. Oh, I can drop assassinate him now. That's right. Come check out that ghost there. What? Screwed that button up. What is he doing? Kill him. Oh, I threw him the hell off the building. Okay, so I was just talking about controls not sticking and then it stuck on me, but it's all good. We recovered the situation. And so far, the alarm is not triggered. He was gonna be one of the ones that was gonna trigger it, actually. So let's attempt our plan one more time. Oh, look, he left his hat. Oh, there's one of those helix things. You know what? Why not just jump over and grab it? There we go. All right, there's our target. There's someone we can mark. All right, so let's approach this a little stealthily. He's on his way back up. I feel like if I kill him, that's going to sort of demoralize his bros. So let's do that first. Oh, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Oh, snappy, snappy. You know what? Let's not risk it. Let's get behind this thing. Look at that slide. That was so cool. I should light that dynamite right there and just have him walk right up and explode. That would be totally fun, but probably cause some chaos. There should be 12. They were delivered just this morning. This is 10. Identify. Yeah, why not? Flee the area. Ooh. Whoa. Okay. All right, cool. I wonder if we can choke him out instead of killing him. Let's try that. Knock out. Oh, there we go. Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. Whoa. Don't set off the alarm. I was trying to pick him up and carry him over here, but that didn't quite work. He's gonna turn around. No, he's not. Sweet! Okay. We did it. So let's take out a few more of these guys. Savage has that alarm and we are good to go. In fact, let's just see if we can knife this guy right there. That took two for some reason. Let's drop assassinate this guy. Totally did not mean to do that.
Any last words?
She's just tearing this guy up. Look at that. These are the tough ones, too. Can she do it? Can she do it? So close. Oh my god. So close. Well, that was fun. Now we get to free some kids. So this is the fun part here.
You'll be all right. Trust me.
Awesome, awesome. Oh, there's a dude right there. Where'd he come from? something's up. We're just gonna have to throw him over the balcony. See if that works. Almost. Okay. Well, cool. All right, kids. Run, run. You are free.
Look sharp. I will be back.
Thanks.
Upstairs. Okay, there's another way we could have come in. Okay, no problem. Out of the way, adult. We just want to save the kids.
Don't worry.
Thank you, Miss Crow.
Oh, nice, nice. Oh, are they going to get adopted? All right, rock and roll, rock and roll. Okay, so we did not trigger the alarm. Had a few little button snags there, but it seemed like I was pressing the right button there. But anyway, that was awesome. Now we might have some kid spies on our side. We'll see what happens from here. Child liberation complete. Okay, so that liberated an entire new borough there. Well, that's awesome. Okay. I earned another skill point. That make me, I'm still level one. I'm gonna have to research how this works. Why was he, maybe I just have to spend some more points to get more levels. All right, she needed a little help in combat, so let me give her just something. How about just a little health boost? That's what triggers it, okay. I'm learning. Okay, so now we have three to spend, and I can just shoot right down to this next stealth rank. So we are definitely picking that up. Fantastic. On our way to becoming stealth masters. Let's see what these next two are. Even less noise. Oh, that's so cool. All right, guys. Well, thanks so much for tuning in. I really appreciate it. Hope you learned a couple of things in this episode. So we're definitely going to be back with some more Assassin's Creed Syndicate. But in case you want to check out some of my other series, I've got some Call of Duty and some Fallout 4 going on right now as well. For this one particular episode, I'm promoting my extra credit on the Skooled Zone in that right clickable annotation box there. So check that out. These are just bite-sized nuggets that you guys are gonna love. So see what that's all about. Thanks again. Make sure you hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't. What are you waiting for? Fantastic video game factoids delivered to your door. Can't beat that. And we'll see you next time on the Skooled Zone. Stay smart.